In a world of ever-evolving technology and ways to communicate, from the internet, wireless, and TV, to telehealth, remote learning, and gaming, the job of the Federal Communications Commission is to close the digital divide and make sure you have access to the latest and fastest technology. For Ajit Pai, the current chairman of the FCC, it's personal.
I come from rural Kansas, parts of the country that have been on the wrong side of the divide, and that's been a labor of love as well as a professional obligation.
President Obama appointed Pai to serve on the commission in 2011, and in 2017, President Trump designated Pai as chairman. Now, more than halfway through his five-year term, Pai is focused on making sure all Americans have access to fast broadband technology.
Explain to folks at home what 5G is and what it will do to transform their lives.
So many of our viewers, if they're using a smartphone, are probably familiar with 4G LTE, 4G being the fourth generation of wireless connectivity. Well, 5G is the fifth generation, and it promises speeds that are several times, up to 100 times faster than 4G. The responsiveness of 5G networks, you know, the time it takes for you to click a link on your phone and then get a response from the network will be significantly shorter, and it will enable all kinds of services, as many of which we can't even think about today.
5G is designed to connect virtually everyone and everything together, including machines, objects, and devices. Some companies began deploying 5G globally in 2019, and the race is on to make it more broadly available.
Who is leading the 5G rollout in terms of providers right now?
Well, certainly, I think in a global sense, the United States is, in terms of spectrum assets, small cells being deployed and the like. In terms of particular companies, I think a lot of them are participating in our spectrum auctions, all the big names you would know, including some of those you might not expect, cable companies, for example, electric utilities and others. Everybody wants to lead in the 5G space, and I think that's a great thing for consumers to have that kind of competition.
And 5G is already being put to use in several areas, including telehealth, remote learning, precision agriculture, self-driving cars, and even airport scanners.
What are you doing at the FCC to address the security piece of 5G?
You've put your finger on one of the critical issues, and one of our priorities has been not just for America to lead in 5G, but also for us to think about security ahead of time. So we want to make sure that we're thinking about security right now, and we're doing that in a few ways. The FCC, for example, has led the way in prohibiting the use of FCC funding from being used on insecure equipment that comes from Chinese companies Huawei and ZTE. We've also worked with Congress to enable the funding to go to companies that have already installed problematic equipment and replace it with more trustworthy equipment.
Access to broadband has been an issue for many Americans living in rural areas, in part because maps the FCC uses haven't provided sufficient data. This month, Pai says the commission plans to hand out $20 billion to help expand access to those parts of the country that have been underserved in the past.
There's some 10.4 million Americans who will benefit from this particular Rural Digital Opportunity Fund auction. So we're working with Congress to get that funding. I would think in everybody's interest for us to be able to do that work. But in the meantime, we're going to pursue those parts of the country that, again, according to anyone's map, those parts of the country that are on the wrong side of the digital divide.
An advocate of less regulation during his term with the FCC, Pai supports repealing net neutrality, a policy that requires internet service providers to treat all web traffic equally. FCC Commissioner Jessica Rosenworcel says repealing net neutrality is, quote, crazy, adding that the internet should be open and available for all. I asked Chairman Pai to respond to his critics.
Our position was, instead of you regulating the internet heavily like a utility, as the Obama FCC did starting in 2015, we want to make sure that we restore that light touch framework. When we did that, there are all kinds of predictions. This is the end of the internet as we know it. You're going to have to pay $5 per tweet. Americans are going to get kicked off the internet. And fast forward now, almost 3 years later, none of those predictions have proven true. In fact, the internet is 99% faster on average for fixed broadband than it was when we made that decision.
Depending on what happens with the election, the makeup of the FCC could look different in the coming years. Pai says regardless of who wins in November, the priorities of the commission should remain the same.
I would hope that a future FCC would continue our work on Wi-Fi. And Wi-Fi is increasingly important to consumers, regardless of where they live, whether you're at home or on the go. Under my leadership, the FCC, for the first time in a generation, increased by 5x, five times, the amount of spectrum that's available for Wi-Fi. And this is going to transform the consumer experience.
The FCC consists of five commissioners that each serve five-year terms, and they're appointed by the president, and the president also delegates one commissioner as a chairman. Only three commissioners can be on the same political party at any time. Little background for you there. As for net neutrality, the FCC is set to vote on the proposal to reaffirm the 2017 decision to repeal net neutrality on October 27th. So something will continue to follow.